Senator Blakeson, Dr. Rick. Paul and I go back about 30 years almost. Senator, I now want to call you Sam. Your story at TCV reminded me of one of the most emotional moments of recent memory for me, which was this past October with my daughter at TCV.
Say what TCV is.
Tibetan Children's Village in Dharamsala, India, in Himachal Pradesh, meeting for the first time the girl that we have been supporting since my daughter at age 12 volunteered 3 years ago in the library at TCV to help teach English.
Wow, we are connected.
So we are connected.
Wow.
I first encountered some Tibetan Buddhist thought over 40 years ago in a conference on humanistic psychology. Bead of Western academic thought that was committed to viewing the whole person. And that made a gigantic impression when I was only in high school. And now I find myself as the grateful director of a long-term project looking at the effects of long-term meditation through a matrix of extraordinary collaborators and very deeply connected through the Tibetan community. About 20 years ago, I had the good fortune to be asked on a dime to fill in for my colleague and friend and mutual friend with Paul, Richie Davidson, who couldn't go to a meeting in Dharamsala with His Holiness, one of the early-minded life meetings. And I was in graduate school, and 3 weeks later, I was presenting a talk to His Holiness at this distance. I was rooming with a scientist, Francisco Varela, who is one of the intellectual fathers of the dialogue between Tibetan Buddhist thought and Western neuroscience, cognition, psychology. And he said, we should do a project. And Alan was the translator, Alan Moss was the translator for this. So 2 years later, we actually did a field study with advanced practitioners in retreat in the mountains on Baksu Mountain above McLeod, you know, Ganja, above Dongkot, for those of you who are locals. And this was an incredibly inspiring project. But you know, we brought about 1,200 pounds of equipment and Western psychological tasks, but it really was cross-culturally rather naive. So it was incredibly inspiring, but it was also very difficult to do empirical research. And these folks were so extraordinary that we spent time with. We thought we needed to do longitudinal studies in the West, because extraordinary individuals, they always have been extraordinary. That's why they're in retreat, and that's why they're deep contemplative practitioners. So I came to Davis. Alan Wallace, who had been the translator of worlds for that project for us, brought the idea to do the Shamatha project to my colleagues and myself at UC Davis. And he originally wanted to study 3 years of full-time meditation. That's rather arduous. And think about a control group for those individuals. So we settled for a one-year project. Well, that was very exciting scientifically, but very expensive. So 7 years ago, we began a pilot project of only 3 months of training, but that could have a control group. It's turned out to be a multi-million dollar 12-year project that we thought was this very small pilot study. But my colleagues at UC Davis and actually all around the world have been working to tease out various aspects of human experience that shift when one commits to looking deeply within, cultivating a relaxed, still mind, and generating beneficial attitudes suffering, for genuine happiness for yourself and others. And we've found improved visual perception, improved ability to withhold from habitual responses. Being able to withhold from habitual sort of knee-jerk responses actually predicts improved psychological function. We've found that changes in psychological traits, such as a sense of purpose of your life, actually correlates with the level of an enzyme that repairs the shortening of your chromosomes that happens as cells divide and you age. This is work in collaboration with Lisa Ethel, Liz Blackburn, written by postdoc foundations in the laboratory. Liz Blackburn won the Nobel Prize for discovering telomerase. So contemplative practice can shift psychology that can modulate a biological system at the level of your chromosomes that may be related to health and longevity. So it is with great honor that I've been asked to say a few words here, and I thank you so much for your attention. Philosophy training is the single thing